Good evening. Welcome. Turn off your cell phones. Okay? Let's not have anybody's mind ring in my ears. But you don't hear that. Anyway, welcome. We have a lovely service as usual. I see a lot of new faces. We'll be out there to get you. And Shabbat Shalom.
Welcome, everyone. Tonight, of course, we're celebrating several occasions, and we are commemorating an occasion. We want to pay tribute to all the mothers, grandmothers, would-be mothers, wannabe mothers. And also, we want to pay tribute to our brethren and sisters in the land of Israel as they just completed celebrating their independence. And of course, we're going to honor the men and women who served our country and who paid the ultimate price for that service. And tonight we will also, as I've done ever since it started, honor the memories of those who perished in the pandemic and those who are now suffering and fighting for their freedom and their lives in Ukraine. So we have a full evening filled with joy and with sadness, but that is the journey of life that we all take. And so I'm going to ask now for the choir to lead us in El Kole. Now we begin our Shabbat service with the lighting of the Shabbat candles, and I ask you to turn to page 65.
And I call Hannah Oyer. As these candles give light to all who behold them, so may we give light to all who behold us, as their brightness reminds us of the generations of Israel who have kindled light, so may we, in our own day, be among those who kindle light. We praise you, eternal God, sovereign of the universe. You hallow us with your mitzvot and command us to kindle the lights of Shabbat. Let there be joy.
Let there be
peace.
Let there be Shabbat.
Well, all I can tell you is for 30 years, and we will commemorate it soon, you have brought light into our lives. And through your efforts with the choir and everything that you do for this congregation, so we thank you for bringing joy into our hearts and light into our lives.
And thank you for letting me do all this.
Send a check. And now we'll join together with the Cantor and Choir as they join in welcoming Sabbath Bride, Lecha Dodi, page 66. Page 67, in the center of the page, we read responsively, O source of light and truth, creator of the eternal law of goodness and of the impulse within us for justice and mercy, we pray that this hour of worship may be one of vision and inspiration. Help us to find knowledge by which to live. Lead us to take the words we shall speak into our hearts and into our lives. On page 68, the emphasis of the prayer we just read, Hinei Matov, how good it is for all people, to come together in unity. Hinei Matov. Turn to page 69 for the introduction to the call to worship.
Ooh, okay. We now call Eve Wagner and Joanne Rubenstein to open the ark.
Please
Page 70, the call to worship.
Thank you.
remain standing as we turn to page 71 in the middle of the page. One and only God, you have made each of us unique and formed us to be united in one family of life. Be with us, Eternal One, as we seek to unite our lives with your power and your love. Let us join together now with the Cantor and Choir in the affirmation of our faith, the Shema Yisrael. Everyone together, hear, O Israel, the Eternal is our God, the Eternal God alone. Blessed is God's glorious majesty forever and ever. Please be seated. On page 73, we read responsively, in a world torn by violence and pain, a world far from wholeness, a world waiting still to be redeemed, give us, O source of good, the courage to say, there is one God in heaven and earth. From Egypt, the house of bondage, we were delivered at Sinai amid peals of thunder. We bound ourselves to your purpose, inspired by prophets and instructed by sages. We survived oppression and exile time and again, overcoming the forces that would have destroyed us. May this vision never fade. Let us continue to work for the day when the nations will be one and at peace. Then shall we sing with one accord, as Moses, Miriam, and Israel sang at the shores of the sea, the Michamocho, the song of glory, after they witnessed the most amazing miracle ever, the parting of the sea and the salvation of the people. Michamocho.
Thank you.
turn to page 76, and we ask you to rise.
I now call Helen and Michael Freshenmeyer to open the ark.
Responsively, we read, Your might, O God, is everlasting.
Help us to use thy strength for good.
You are the source of life and blessing.
Help us to use thy power for ourselves and our children.
You are the support of the falling.
Help us to lift up the fallen.
You are the author of freedom.
Help us to free the captive.
You are our hope in death as in life. Your might, O God, is everlasting. Please be seated. Close. Thank you. On page 78, we join with the choir and the cantor in the rendering of Yismachu, the joy of Shabbat. Page 79. Dear God, you are with us in our prayer, in our love, and our doubt, in our longing to feel your presence and do your will. You are the still, clear voice within us. Therefore, O God, when doubt troubles us, when anxiety makes us tremble, and pain clouds the mind, we look inward for the answer to our prayers. There may we find you, and there find courage, insight, and endurance. And let our worship bring us closer to one another, that all Israel and all who seek you may find strength in your service. Amen. On page 80, Let us take a few moments now for silent meditation. Now I'm going to ask us to think about those who are infirm, those who need an extra help in reaching recovery, that our prayers will be answered so that God will be able to help us all heal as we overcome the difficulties we face. You know, I've said it numerous times and I'll say it again, this congregation is filled with miracles. On Hanukkah, you've heard, and I've said it tonight earlier, Nes Gadol Hayasham, when it talks about a miracle happened here, this congregation is a miracle walking, a miracle standing, a miracle that we've survived what we've encountered over these last 2 years. Our prayers help. Let's see if we can send them to others who need our assistance as well. So call out the names of those who are infirmed, so that we can have them in our hearts and minds when we render the Mishaberach prayer. We have all these people in our hearts and minds, all people throughout the world who are suffering now from illnesses and disease and famine, who need help, and only we can be the instrument to get that help for them. And let us join now together with the Cantor and Choir with the Mishaberach prayer on the inside cover of your prayer book.
Thank you.
prayer and answer us with his curing powers. Amen. Let us now turn to page 142 as we begin the process of reading from Scripture from the Torah.
For Gabbais, I call Alan Bear and Karen Bialis to open the Ark, Mel Moss and Arnie Hendon, to carry the Torahs, Mel Moss and Arnie Hendon.
Rabbono Shalolam, Master of the Universe, we ask you to inspire us with your teachings and your commandments to love and uphold our precious democracy. Let every citizen take responsibility for the rights and the freedoms we all cherish. Let each of us be an advocate for justice, an activist for liberty, a defender of dignity. And let us champion the values that make our nation a haven for the persecuted, a beacon of hope among the nations. We pray for all who serve our country with selfless devotion in peace and in war, from fields of battle to clinics and classrooms, from government to the grassroots, all those whose noble deeds and sacrifice benefit our nation and our world. We pray for your wisdom and moral strength, that we may be guardians of these rights for ourselves and for the sake of all people. And let us say, Amen. Amen. Now to turn to page 143 as we join together in reaffirming our faith once more with the Shema Yisrael.
Shema Yisrael,
seated. Okay, tonight we are in the third book of the Torah, and in that book we are learning more and more about holiness and sanctification and what it means to be holy. Everybody has a different concept of holiness. Some people think of kashrut, the observance of kashrut, as being holy. Some people think praying three times a day is a fundamental of holiness. Some people think of treating others as you would want to be treated as holiness. There are different concepts of holiness. None of them are wrong, and all of them are right. So what we have to determine when emphasizing what we think we should be doing, it has to be what we imagine that separating ourselves from things that are not so tasteful into things that are. And that's what holiness is all about, separation. To make yourselves a little different than you were the day before or the day before that. Holiness is a concept that gives us the ability to be closer, not only to God, but to one another. Because if we can't treat ourselves with the dignity we deserve, then how do we expect God to treat us with the dignity we're looking for? So it's a combination of two, a combination of understanding that God is there to guide, not to condemn, and we are there to put our best foot forward in trying to do the things that we know that are morally acceptable in this universe in which we live. That is the most difficult part of being holy. So tonight we'll read a little bit about how we can achieve that distinction with certain things that we can observe. For example, the first one we're going to read deals with the belief that to treat parents with dignity and respect is one of the highest moral obligations we have in the world. None of us were asked to be born, but here we are, and we have an obligation to show that respect and dignity to our parents for whatever they did or didn't do. You know, as time goes on, we can conjure up in our minds all different things that could have been or should have been or would have been. That's not the issue today. The issue is to teach us that there is a certain dignity that's essential for us to have a relationship with one another. And it starts off with parents. For the first honor, we call Dresel Hendel Bat Yosef and Zvi Hirsch Ben Yosef and Sarah Zelma.
Diane and Greg Kozniak.
Baruch Adonai
and Baruch Le'olam Bo'ed.
Baruch Adonai and Baruch Le'olam Bo'ed. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher bachar banu mikol hamun v'natan lanu et Torato. Baruch atah Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen. Vayidaber Adonai el Moshe le'mer daber el kol adat b'nei Yisrael v'yomater alayhem kadoshim ti'iyu ki kadosh ani Adonai Eloheichem. And it talks about God said, you should be holy because I am holy.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torah emet V'chaye olam nata b'tochenu, Baruch atah Adonai, notein ha-Torah.
Amen.
For the second and final Aliyah, we call Avraham Yosef and Leah Rivka. Couldn't read my own right.
Leah and Al.
Amen. Ish imo v'aviv tiru v'yet shavatai tishmaru ani Adonai Eloheichem. And here it talks about fearing your mother and your father. Now the rabbis have had a field day with that one. We understand fearing of a father, because the father is usually the one that punishes, so we have a natural fear for the father. But the mother is someone we love, someone we're there and is with us all the time. But the Torah is trying to emphasize that the familiarity of being with your mother all the time should not detract from the fact that she is deserving of the same respect and fear that you give your father.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu Torah emet, v'chayei olam natah v'tuchenu, Baruch atah Adonai, notein haTorah.
Amen. Thank you. And now as we prepare the Torah to be returned to the Ark, we turn to page 145.
I now call for Hagba and Delila, Wendy and Alex Goldstein.
Let us please stand. Continue on page 146 as we begin to return the Torah to the Ark. Behold, a good doctrine has been given you, my Torah. Do not forsake it. It is a tree of life to those who hold it fast, and all who cling to it find happiness. Its ways are ways of pleasantness, and all its paths are peace.
Praise God in me,
One thing is for sure, I don't think I have to be reminding anybody. We're living in very distressing times. There is domestic violence, we see it daily. There is international terror, we see it every day. And all of these things combined have taken untold lives for no reason. Our economic uncertainties vex us to shifts in attitudes that move as fast as our dates, our doubts. Everywhere we turn, the news is depressing. It is now so numbing that we are amazed if a day passes that does not contain some horror. Imagine, if you will, 4,000 years ago, a simple shepherd named Abraham, content with all that life had to offer, receives a message. And the message? Take your son Isaac to Mount Moriah, and there you will sacrifice him to God. No debate, no doubt, just blind obedience. Can anyone sitting here today, or anywhere, imagine receiving such a call and answering it as we understood and understand that Abraham did? The angels may have saved Isaac, but the doubt of such a request lingers. That we would even consider such a test of faith boggles the imagination. Elie Wiesel, of blessed memory, wrote a cantata involving this story in which he laments, "Do you, God, recall the sacrifice requested over there on Mount Moriah? Among all the men on earth, it was me that you claimed. In the Holocaust, you made me climb and descend Mount Moriah, crushed and silent. I did not know, my Lord, I did not know if I was to see my children, old and young, arrive in the flames of hate. Alas, there was no rescuing angel." And here we have a man, Elie Wiesel, who survived the horrendous ordeal to become an author, a husband, a father, and most of all, a humanitarian. We look around us and we see illness and despair. We visit tragedies and look for consolation. Think about all the horrors that have been experienced by so many people, perpetrated by a few, and then ask, has been asked so many times, for what, O Lord, for what? When we measure our discomfort with life to the forgotten, perhaps we can determine that life with all its difficulties is not that bad. We may endure pain for a moment, but lifelessness, that's forever. Is it a coincidence or even ironic that the Israelite temple was built on Mount Moriah? To me, it is a lesson in survival. To me, it is a lesson in fortitude. To me, it is a symbol of faith. On the very spot where humanity almost died, a new chapter in the people's journey began. We just celebrated that anniversary in Israel independence. To me, it is also a clear message that our humanity's search for understanding took a new turn, a new route, as we learned from the prophet Hosea. Take your words to God, he says. Everyone needs to take their words, whether they are words of praise or of condemnation, to God. We are given, if you will, a permission slip by tradition to yell, to scream, to bargain, with God. Remember, Abraham tried to save the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. He argued with God and bargained with him. If you do this, I'll do that. If you do this, I'll do that. That's our right. We are called Israel because it means to struggle with God. How do you struggle with God if you are complacent and obedient and not questioning? I remember one other thing Elie Wiesel said, and it's so true today as it was then. You can live with God, you can live against God, but you cannot live without God. Words are the essential ingredient in communicating with one another. And these words, which contain all the thoughts of whatever we are thinking, remind us that even as we question and utter words of disgust, and even words of despair, we also announce, because that's who we are, we say, it's God's will. The challenges we face in life contain all these doubts and fears, but they also contain the ingredients of hope and faith. We question, we doubt, we argue, we even become faithless at times, but here we are. Are we wondering if all that we know and yet to learn has any meaning? Has life any meaning, any purpose? The challenges we face, and we see them every day, include speaking out when we witness injustice or the indiscriminate annihilation of innocent people for no other reason than we don't like them. They're different than we are. Or challenge the right for anyone to worship God however they think that worship should be intoned. We need to be able to fight tyranny and hatred. We see it in the world today, and if we just do nothing, it will continue forever and ever. All of us cannot be legions in the fight for survival, but we can and must support those institutions that are designed to lead the fight and show the way. Starting with the synagogue, this is how we participate. We are a different kind of soldier. A soldier who proudly declares that life is worth living, and we are part of the response available to us to ensure that life continues. Above all, the challenges we face each and every day involves the understanding that even when we feel helpless, we still speak out in the hope that someone will hear, someone will listen. There will be victories, and yes, there will be defeats. But even when we lose, we win because we say the words and perform the deeds that will forever change the world. And it has. Amen. hardly woke us up. So now I know if I put you to sleep, we always have the choir that'll take care of. And now it's time to recognize all those celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. And so we're going to call out names, and then those of you who are here will be asked to come to the altar for your blessing.
And a happy anniversary. Whoops. Happy anniversary to Ron and Victoria Gindick, Alan and Marilyn Baer, Myron and Kara Bernstein, Barry and Joan Berger, Alex and Wendy Goldstein, Michael and Regina Milgram. And a happy birthday, we've got a long list here. Gary Hossenfuss, Barbara Israel, Sharon Becker, Arthur Fink, Barbara Reese, Edie Evans, Robert Kleiman, Bernice Freitag, Lana Oyer, Joanne Rubenstein, Wendy Goldstein, boy, double ceremony, Jocelyn Rick, Michael Kaplan, Ann Bomerand, Alex Goldstein, oh my goodness, Bernard Lieberman, Chuck Rappaport, Mark Salita, Jan Rappaport, Sandy Jennings, Noel Levine, Eve Wagner, Victoria Gindick, Jeannie Capoletto, Steve Kubrin, Sally Shear, and Elaine Zolte. Happy birthday and happy anniversary to all of you.
Those of you who are here celebrating birthdays and anniversaries, please come forward. Where's Lana? Well, we're starting to get back in shape again. And everyone that's here today is celebrating a special occasion. Every day is a special occasion, but sometimes we exaggerate the years and months rather than the days. But here we are celebrating anniversaries and birthdays, and all of you are smiling and laughing and happy. And that's important for us too, because we've survived many things in this congregation, the least of which was the pandemic for the last 2 years. So we're so glad to be here today and to celebrate joyous occasions. So you have a birthday, birthday, birthday?
39.
39, okay.
Birthday.
Anniversary.
Birthday and anniversary.
Okay, that's called a double whammy. Birthday. Arthur, how are you doing? Good, good to see you. Good to see everyone. And now, in behalf of the congregation, the Cantor and Choir are going to render the Shechionu prayer, thanking God for all the blessings we receive every single day of every single year. Bless you, and thank you for sharing your joy with us on this occasion of Shabbat blessings. Thank you.
Service, please stand up so we can meet you, hear from you, talk to me. Come on.
Catherine Solansky, my husband, from Casa Grande.
Good.
And yes, originally we were from Illinois and Ohio.
Okay, now the glasses come off because I have to read. All right. Services. Who did I miss? Who didn't stand up?
Yeah.
Who? Who didn't stand up? Come on. Who did I miss? She's not new. All right. Just remember that services will be June 10th, and of course, the taping will be the last taping we will be doing, and it will be shown the following Friday. It'll be available, and we will be having Twilight services in July, August, and September because of the high holidays. They're late, so we'll have a Twilight service in September. That way we can kind of rekindle our friendships for those lucky ones that get away for the summer. The JWV is having a wonderful program on Sunday at the Poolside Cafe. It is the person that's speaking, his name is Paula Pending, and she's a decorated U.S. Naval vet. She is also the voice of the Arizona Republic vet. She is one of the first whistleblowers of the Phoenix VA. So she's very interesting. She has a book. She will sign books, and she will be a very, very interesting speaker. So 10 o'clock on Sunday, this Sunday, at Poolside Cafe here in Oakwood. All right, let me see here. All right, well, thank you to those of you that attended the fundraiser that we had this past Tuesday at BJ's. It was wonderful, and we thank you, and we thank Linda Brooks for organizing it again. Linda, you're doing a great job. Thank you, thank you. To our sisterhood, congratulations on another successful card party and the wonderful, generous donation they are making to the congregation. Should I tell them? No? Yes? No? $8,500. We need it, people. We need it. Okay. The owning will be in the Chapel Center, and it's an ice cream social, something different. I think I may write that in my letter, but just to remind you. Another thing, I will be gone all summer, and just know that I am available by phone. And it will be in the June spiel, my phone number. It's going to be forwarded, so you can call me. And I also will be working on the High Holiday Honors. So those of you that want to participate, please don't be shy. Let me know. It'll make my job easier. I don't have to make 100 phone calls, okay? Trying to get all of you to come. And it's not that hard. It's not nerve-wracking, you know, is it? No. Oh. Anyway, all right. Then, of course, we want to thank these wonderful people up here on the Bema, our wonderful Rabbi, our wonderful Cantor, our choir director, Lana, who's celebrating her 39th birthday, and our choir. You just make our services so wonderful. Yvonne, back there on our stand, and Doug, who does our setup, the Rangers. They are, please, please thank them when you leave. They want us to do a change of entrance for next month. I don't know if we'll do it. We'll see what happens. And Roxy, of course, thank her when you go over to the Onig. She put that room together all by herself. Just thank her. And of course, he's standing back there being shy. Our accompanist, Shay, and our taper. Okay, whatever we want to call you. Okay. All right, and remember to tell your friends that have not made it to services that the service will be available by next Friday to view on YouTube. I want to say safe travels to all of you that are leaving for the summer. Please be safe, stay healthy, and I look forward to seeing you at the September Twilight Service. What did I forget? Oh, the flowers. How can I do that? I have that note and I forgot. These beautiful flowers were donated tonight by Len Dolman's in honor of Lana's birthday. I think I'm done.
Okay. We're going to continue now with two things, one in honor of Israel and the other in honor of our own country and the people who serve it, starting with the HaTikvah, and then This Is My Country. Let us please stand. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
seated. And now the cantor will lead us in the Kiddush, page 165.
I call for the motzi, Arthur Fink.
The service, the adoration, you can find on page 148. Let us please stand.
We now call Elaine and Seymour Zolte, open the ark.
Teach us more and more to respond to the pain of others, to heed your call for justice, that we may bring near the day when all the world shall be one. On that day, the age-old dream shall come true. On that day, O God, you shall be one, and your name shall be one.
Amen.
Let us remain standing, and as we've done from the very beginning, we will do moles for several occasions that we're commemorating tonight. One is for the victims of the pandemic, and as we've been told, as of yesterday, close to 1 million people of our citizens have succumbed to this dreaded disease. So the first memorial prayer are for those victims. The second one will be in memory of all the men and women who served our country in the field of battle and were also lost in that terrible ordeal or ordeals. In memory of all who served our country. Custom as well. The men, women, and children who have suffered unmeasurable and untold death at the hands of terrorists in a city and towns of a country called Ukraine. We render the El Mole Rachamim.
Thank you.
compassionate God, eternal spirit of the universe, we ask you to grant perfect rest in your sheltering presence to all who have succumbed to terror and disease and who have now entered eternity. O God of mercy, let them all find refuge in your eternal presence, and let their souls be bound up in the bond of everlasting life. God, you are surely their inheritance. May they all rest in peace. And let us say, Amen. And now it is our time to pay tribute, to memorialize our loved ones whom we commemorate at this time.
Page 153. However brief may be our time on earth, O God, you endow our fleeting days with abiding worth. We now recall the loved ones whom death has recently taken from us. And as we remember those who died at this season in years past, we take them into our hearts with our own. In this moment of memory, our griefs and sympathies are mingled. Loving God, we praise your name.
We commemorate the Yahrzeits this month of Rosalyn Algranati, Bruce Arbiter, Eugene Baer, Donald Bendick, Janet Bell, Irving Bialis, Rose Brenwear, Albert Burns, Robert Cantor, David Capilotto, James Klein, Joseph Cohn, Samuel Cohn, Donald Currens, Charles Feinberg, Dorothy Fink, Leon Fisher, Jerome Fisher, Shirley Francis, Elliot Frank, Harry Freienthal, Dorothy Freienthal, Edward Frey, Fila Fried, Martin Garber, Sue Gerson, Karen Ann Gersten, Clarence Goldman, Mitzi Goldman, Sarah Granoff, Albert Hendon, Barbara Lubisch, Ivanhoe, Eva Katcher, Henry Kochman, Jeff Crone, Herman Levinson, Ruth Leviton, Sharon Levy, Sylvia Levy, Jerome Mendelson, Morris Murdovitz, Birgit Metzer, Gretel Moses, Larry Moss, Alva Nelson, Julius Nagelis, Darnell Owens, David Parker, Joseph Pincus, Anna Price, Mildred Roth, Sarah Sheck, Jacob Scharf, Arthur Siegel, Ruth Siegel, Norman Spear, Malcolm Steinberg, Seymour Wiener, Edith Weisenberg, Meyer Wiener, Leon Winter, Henry Arthur Zellinger. We have all of these people in our hearts and minds, the men and women and children who perished in the Holocaust as well, and we recite together the prayer offering God their eternal rest. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shmei Rabbah, b'yalma divrach rute v'yamlich malchute, v'chayichon v'yimeichon v'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael, ma'agol v'zman koriv v'yimru amen. Yehei shmei Rabbah mevorach li'olam lomei l'mayer, yitvorach v'yishtabach v'yitpoar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh, V'yid Adar, V'yid Alev, V'yid Alal, Shemei D'Kudusha Barichu, Le'elam in Kol Berichoto V'Shiroto, Tushbechoto V'Nechemoto, Na'amiran B'Alma V'Imru, Amen. Yehei Shlomo Rabo Min Shemayo, V'Chayim Aleinu V'Al Kol Yisrael, V'Imru, Amen. Oseh Shalom B'Mermav, Uya Seh Shalom, Aleinu V'Al Kol Yisrael, V'imru, Amen. And we pray that the source of peace will send peace to all who mourn and comfort to all who are bereaved. And let us say, Amen. Now, you've been standing a long time, so please be seated. We will conclude the service tonight, and we will until the end of this war. Let there be peace on earth. Thank you. job is taken. And now the final benediction. You may remain seated. May God bless you and keep you. And may God's countenance shine upon you, and may He be gracious to all of you. Extend His greatest blessings to all of us, the blessings of peace. Amen. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Join us for ice cream.
And tonight is an ice cream social. Vanilla, chocolate, strawberry.